All right. So we're going to work on this image here. As you can see, I have opened it up into Lightroom. I start all my edits in Lightroom, and I'm now going to play, what do I call them in here? Preset that I've created that I put over all my images before I take them over into Photoshop. All right, so I just adjust as needed. Over here. So when I'm working with lighter colored images, I don't want to taint it too much with a yellow temperature. So that's why I just bring down the temperature a little bit. Okay. Now I'm going to open this, take it over into Photoshop now. And hopefully it won't take 10 years to do. And cross fingers, my girls remain happy and they don't start screaming the house down while I'm trying to do this video for you guys. So, come on. Oh, there we go. We're in the camera roll format. Good job. All right, so I just got to remember that when you're working in between Lightroom and Photoshop, that they work in different color profiles. So I always convert my image when I open it across to work in the color space that I want when I'm in Photoshop. Okay, so first things first, create a background layer. So I've created little shortcuts for myself just to save myself time. So I'm not having to, you know, go up to the menu and then select different things. Just makes life a lot easier. Alright, just going to slightly rotate this so it's at the angle that I want it to be. I generally try to stick to the rule of thirds whenever I'm working with any of my images. So as you can see, I have the eye line on the third line here. I might take that up just a little bit higher. Alright. Now I don't worry too much about, you know, extending out of my image for my background because I know that I can just clone it and fix it up. Alright. Pretty happy with that. We'll see how it comes together. Alright. So now I am going to fix up this background. I'm going to use my clone tool. This big brush. A sample, paint it in. Ooh, little toes. Ah, more little toes. See, even I make mistakes. Get rid of that. Extend this here. Let's see. Can you hear YouTube in the background there? My life is listening to Cookie Swell C, I swear. Alright, so we're just going to flatten that down now. I'm happy with that. Now what I usually do is I've created my own actions that I use. And then I also use some actions from Kelly Brown for when I'm working on the skin tones and also with the skin smoothing and just defining the eyes. So usually the brush that I work with most of the time, you know, I try to lower the opacity of it, and you know, less is more for me with my workflow. You know, I don't want to change it too much, I just want to enhance what I've already got. A little bit of contrast. And then I'm gonna, oh actually I will do the background blur. So soft background blur. This one I will do it 100%. I just wanna take the photo. focus off anything that the focus shouldn't be on by doing this. Now, it's really important when you're using this background blur brush that you don't try to blur anything that you haven't blurred when you've taken the shot, because it's very easy to see that it was never blurred in the first place. Okay, so a good way to check if you want to see where it's been painted on is I just press the backsplash button, and I can see where I may have missed or where I may have gone too far. Just simply press the X button, and that changes my brush from painting on to painting off however I need it. Okay, so just a little bit of blur, just enough. Is to soften the baby's skin. I apologise if you can hear my husband playing his game downstairs. I promise you, we do not have World War III going on in our lounge room. It's just battlefield. Right. I'm just going to smooth that out, lower the opacity of it. Make sure that I haven't got it on the eye lines or anything that I don't want it on. Got a bit of a beautiful cream skin. I always lower the opacity to sit around 40% on this one. Just put that on where I want it. If I'm not sure, I'll generally just bring down the opacity here. Bring a little bit of definition into those beautiful closed eyes, and then I will also shine on just soft pink cheeks, it's called, just to bring back a little bit of colour that I may have taken out when I did my lightening of the skin reds. Give this baby a little soft blush. Just enough to be noticeable. Now, see underneath, baby skin tones, you know, sometimes are quite difficult to get it even and, you know, nice, and sometimes just underneath their nose and on their top lip, they can look a little bit blue, a little bit purple. So in that instance, what I will do is I'll just add a little colour back in. So I'll do a colour balance layer. Let's see how that went. See, now that's without. And then when I put it back in, it's so subtle. But the more you do this, the more you can see it. And, you know, the better you become at creating that consistently gorgeous, smooth, clean newborn skin look. And they're perfect. They really are. They're perfect the way they are. But sometimes the camera just picks up things that you didn't even know were there. So you just put a little bit of warmth back in underneath that nose. I'm going to flatten that one down. Now, this is where I would normally, you know, come in nice and close. If I had to correct anything, I'd come over to my spot heel brush. That's what I like to use. If there were any, you know, major blemishes, then, you know, you'd fix them up. Look at this, it's just perfect. Very minimal that I have to do here. We'll stay here. Any other little things that picks up? present, and I just put a layer over the top. It's called, it's my fifth season photography skin. It's what I do for the image. And what I'm working with white, I'll put this one over the top. The clean haze, I'll add a layer to it. Black brush, brush it off just on the face there. 40%. Cool. Then what I will do is I'll run a sharpen layer that I've created. So you can see that just really defines all the things that were once a little bit blurry. Sharpens them right back up again. Sometimes 45% is a little bit too much, so I'll bring it down to 30. So it's still soft, but it's sharp at the same time. Oxymoron, I don't know. Okay. Flatten that down. Now this is where, depending on what image I'm working on, I'll always go over the top of it with a brush, just to even out any colours. So I'll do a sample. Bring it down to about 20%. And I'm just going to brush this on. And what this does is it just creates an even colour over the whole one. So if you don't know how to sample like that, I'll just show you again. Alright, so just on your background layer that you that's without. That's it. So, create a background layer, hold in the Alt key, bring up the eyedropper, and you select whichever colour you think is closest to what you want to work with. So, you know, I could even do the little blanket or wrap here, 20%, brush it on. When I'm working with my dark backgrounds and my wood, I'll sample on the wood and I'll brush, you know, a really nice light brown over the top of them. I'm happy with that. I'm just going to make sure that none of this has gone onto her beautiful little skin. I use a very soft brush so I don't get any real hard lines on any of this. About 50% hardness. We don't actually go any harder than that. Take it off this beautiful little bonnet. There we go. So, we've even got the colour tones. Flatten that down. I don't generally run a vignette when I'm working with lighter colours. I'm going to save that. Photoshop. When I press save, it automatically saves a copy of what I've just done. Straight back into Lightroom for me. I don't even have to do anything. It just does it all for me. It's super smart. Alright. So, the start of it. The end of it. We're done. One little perfect sleepy baby. With a beautiful little lace on it. Perfect. Ready to print. Ready to put up on the walls for her beautiful parents. Alright guys, that's it. If you have any questions, please, feel free to ask away. I'm always here to answer your questions. And I hope you enjoyed that one. Alright, until next time. Take care. See ya.